afternoon, everybody. I'd like to welcome all of you here and thank you for being a part of this wonderful occasion. We're here today to help Brian and Chris celebrate their love and commitment to each other. Over the course of the past few months, I've had quite a few conversations with Chris and Brian, and they both agree that a successful marriage will require love, patience, forgiveness, and a sense of humor. Not necessarily in that order. Each of you was invited to this event because you are an important part of Chris and Brian's lives. Some of you have known them for a few years, and others have known them since birth. Whatever the connection may be, your presence today, your friendship, and your love will always be remembered and appreciated. To Brian and Chris, you are surrounded by your friends and family who have come together to celebrate the love that you have found in each other and for each other. By being here with you, each of us is declaring our support for your marriage. To everyone in attendance, you are the community that have supported Chris and Brian throughout their lives, and now you are the community that will support them in their future. May all of you be ready to offer support when it is needed and have the wisdom to know when it is not. I'd like to ask one of Brian's best friends, Bob Sheldon, to come up and read a passage written by June Carter.
Hello, I was asked to read this by Reverend Lynn Dempsey. It's a reading from Johnny Cash to the Corinthians. A ring of fire. Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, down, down. And the flames went higher. And it burns, burns, burns. The ring of fire, the ring of fire. The taste of love is sweet when hearts like ours meet. I fell for you like a child. Oh, but the fire went wild. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher, and it burns, burns, burns. The ring of fire, the ring of fire.
Thank you, Coach Sheldon. I'd now like to ask Suzanne McLeod, one of Chris's best friends, to read an excerpt from Leaves of Grass by Walt Whitman.
Love the earth and the sun and the animals. Despise riches. Give alms to everyone that asks. Stand up for the stupid and crazy. Devote your income and labor to others. Hate tyrants. Argue not concerning God. Have patience and indulgence towards the people. Take off your hat to nothing known or unknown. Go freely with powerful, uneducated persons, along with the young and the mothers or families. Re-examine all you've been told in school or church or by any book, and dismiss whatever insults your own soul.
I've known Chris and Brian separately, and I've known them together. I'm certainly not the only person in attendance tonight that will tell you that they truly are a perfect match. They love their families, they love their friends, and they love each other. Brian, in the presence of your family and friends, do you choose Chris to laugh with you in joy, to grieve with you in sorrow, and to grow with you in love? Chris, in the presence of your family and friends, do you choose Brian to laugh with you in joy, to grieve with you in sorrow, and to grow with you in love? The rings that Chris and Brian are about to exchange represent a spiritual union of life and eternity. The wedding ring is an outward sign of your love and commitment to each other, and I will now ask you to repeat after me. Chris, please take this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment. Brian, please take this ring as a symbol of my love of Meehan. Chris and Brian, you have declared your love today in the presence of your family and friends. May the life that you share be healthy, committed, and filled with love and laughter. I can't let an entire ceremony go by without somehow tying in Brandeis. After all, Brandeis is where I met Chris and Brandeis is where I met Brian, so in my mind, Brandeis is one of the connections that brought them together. I'm not sure if everyone in the room knows this or not, but Brandeis has sometimes ties to Judaism. And at a Jewish wedding, there is a tradition of the breaking of the glass. This tradition is where the groom typically steps on a glass at the end of the ceremony. I've asked around a lot, heard a lot of different reasons of why this is still done today and what it symbolizes. And since, as Coach Sheldon pointed out, I am the Reverend today, I'm going with the version I like best. Breaking the glass marks the end of the ceremony, plain and simple. It provides family and friends with an opportunity to cheer, to congratulate the happy couple, and to let the party begin. So, in a twist on this tradition, I would like to ask Chris and Brian to be ready to step forward and begin the celebration.
Whoa! Is it plastic?
Just likes me, I guess.
Hit it hard.
All right. So, the one catch, instead of glass, you'll be stepping on empty Guinness cans. After all, as the slogan reads, Guinness is for strength. So by stomping on the cans, you'll begin your life together with strength. I'm truly honored to pronounce Chris and Brian husband and wife.